So, Alec, I call this the triumph of the indexers. We've been talking for years about how everybody is moving into passive funds, index funds, ETFs, and today we're going to get a massive rebalancing. What can we expect at the close?
Well, you know, if we do our job right, Bob, no one's going to know that much happened. You know, we want it to be a very smooth transition. Really, what we're doing with the annual rebalance, we want to have the indices be an accurate representation of what's going on in the real economy. And that means that once a year, we have to update things.
But some you guys can't, I'm sorry to interrupt you, but you can't affect whether all the other investors, as Bob has been talking about, have to buy and sell and move these things around massively as a result. So when you know that those stocks will move even if you're just trying to make these tweaks.
Yeah, I mean, really what we're doing is we want to account for the fact that some stocks have gotten bigger, some have gotten smaller, some now belong in the bigger Russell 1000, some are being downgraded to the Russell 2000, you know, et cetera. From our perspective, the key is to keep the indices representative of the asset classes that the end investor is trying to track. And the way we do that is with the annual reconstitution today.
Yeah. But that doesn't mean we won't have price swings. I mean, in theory, the individual stock should not have price swings, but it sometimes does happen.
Sure, there's no question it's a big day for a lot of the companies, especially some of the smaller ones. But, you know, we try to communicate in a transparent way ahead of time to the market to try to minimize the volatility. The other thing to keep in mind is that the percentage of stocks that are turning over in the Russell 2000 or the Russell 1000 in any given year is relatively small. So your average investor that owns an ETF or an index fund, they're not going to see a big shift one way or the other.
The fact that we've had companies doing so many stock buybacks of late, that influences how big this rebalance is. So which stocks are most likely to be most affected, like Apple, for example?
Well, certainly what we're seeing with this recon is the top five stocks in the Russell 1000 index, the large cap index, are all tech related. Four of the five are technology outright, and the fifth one is Amazon. So that's, a lot of people think of that as tech. Technically, it's in the consumer discretionary sector, but the tech sector is a big winner this year in the recon. It's going to have more weight after today than it did before.
Still, we don't think a lot about Apple when we think about the Russell. We're thinking about the small caps, and that's where a lot of this has to do with index funds. You know, they're so big now. If you want small caps, you buy a Russell 2000 tracker. If you want the S&P, you buy the SPY. So when people do that, that's what causes these price swings, right, Bob?
Right.
I mean, you've talked about
that. Yeah, and maybe you could talk about a good example here. It's GrubHub. GrubHub's had an amazing run. It was 43 a year ago. It's 110, 112. So it's going from the Russell 2000, the small cap index, into the Russell 1000. So at the close today, Alec, there's going to be a lot of people who are indexed to the Russell 2000 who own GrubHub. They're going to sell GrubHub, and the people who are indexed to the 1000, they're going to buy it. And the question is the amount of people buying and selling going to be equal or not? There's certainly going to be money for sale at the close. GrubHub is going to be for sale at the close because there's more money indexed to the Russell 2000.
Yeah, and we do a lot of work ahead of time with our partners to make sure that that is a fairly seamless transaction, and we can match the
partners. Do investors know this? Is they're aware of all of this?
Yeah, I mean, one of the responsibilities as an index provider is that you provide this information out to the public, to everybody at the same time. So when we talk about our partners, we're talking about the big ETF providers, the big index fund providers, and the idea of communicating ahead of time in a transparent way is so they can match these big buy and sell orders so you don't have chaos
so
at the close.
It's their fault if they didn't do this already.
Yeah.
We just
put up the screen there. 10% of the Russell 2000, which is the benchmark for small caps, is controlled by these index funds. That's why this becomes an important event.
Yeah,
this is going to keep going up, that number, essentially.
It's about we have 9 trillion benchmark to the Russell 2000. That includes active and passive.
Wow.
A trillion of that, roughly, is passive money.
That 10% figure would be higher or low when we talk about S&P 500?
You'd probably have to ask S&P on that one.
But I was wondering, because of the Russells, the smaller caps, whether the percentage is higher.
Generally, it's higher.
Yeah.
And there's more money in that situation.
We have a lot of active participation in the small cap space, and we value partnerships with our passive partners as well as active managers that we work with.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.